the fact that you know, he's game enough to say it as is and puts out a message out in front of his church is something, and then it gets, you know, photos and it gets put on social media. That in itself is really, really engaging a lot of people in the conversation, and a lot of people are having a discussion because, you know, a lot of times you can think of it, you think of the, you have the thought, but you don't really have the ability to put it into words. And then he's actually really, really sincerely trying, has amazingly touched so many people's hearts into action, which is a good action. Because it's the fear. It's about, like I said, you know, when that issue of the burqa was being discussed in Parliament, Muslim women quickly came out to respond in the same way about, you know, how we see the outcome of that. And there was a lot of people who really engaged with us and really supported the fact of the freedom of choice to dress or undress the way that you want. And I think when it comes down to Muslims, people can't make choices anymore, or can't see that these Muslims are people who belong to a faith. You know, they're seeing people who are in the media is projected as people who belong to a group like the Qaeda, like, you know, those ISIS. So we need to bring that back. And I think what Father's doing is bringing life and bringing humanity and the soul back into society by putting out, you know, God bless, you know, the burqa. There's so much in that. You know, and if it makes other people uncomfortable, it needs to be recognized, and they need to know why are they uncomfortable, and really start to ask those questions, because it's very sad for me to see and have lived and worked as an Australian Muslim woman over the many years to see how sometimes I'm seeing society is slowly deteriorating. Social cohesion is in food and sharing clothes, but what about sharing the soul of humanity? I think that's what's been brought up in this church here.